who's next? Yes, sir. Play some drums. You know some songs?
Just up for a jam, I guess.
Okay. You want to play some guitar?
Yeah, sure.
Reluctantly, he comes up.
I hope they do. You gotta check out Little Ben too on guitar. He's going to jam.
Oh yeah. But yeah, do you guys know stuff together?
Yeah. You wanna play, Ben?
You wanna play now, Ben?
Yeah, go for it, man.
I promise I've got no bugs will bite you today. I got some off earlier on, and I sprayed it all over the place. Some off and some raid, and I got some, I got a no pest strip up also. Ben was a little upset because we jammed before, I think, and some monstrous beast crawled on his leg and bit him right in the middle of it. He had an unfair disadvantage as a result.
You know, for the love of God? Oh, see, I don't know that one. now we're in trouble. The bass player doesn't know it. Any bass players know that?
What song?
What song is it again?
Bass player that can play a technical
double kick. I need a double kick for that one. Double kick.
Oh, yeah.
It's got some double kick.
Yeah, I'll double kick.
The band's falling apart already. Before our first rehearsal.
What else you got, Ben? What else would you feel comfortable playing if it wasn't that song? Just jam or anything.
Just jam.
Yeah. What key is good for you? B minor? A minor? F sharp suspended 11? B minor, we'll do that. Just get a beat from this drummer friend of yours, and we'll lay it down, and you will show us some cool stuff. Good idea. Enough volume in the area. Okay, good. All right.
Is that a
beat?
Yeah. Thanks
for safety.
No.
Strap too short?
No.
Oh, it shouldn't fall off. Should be all right. So you bolted on like mine never comes off. So no matter what in the world ever happens, my strap cannot ever come off, no matter what. So you get supreme confidence because your strap will never come off. You're not going to be at a disadvantage now like that? There's more bucks on there. Get in here, come on. Okay, here we go. Give us a beat. Ben is going to do some solo in E minor, and we're going to lay it down for him. We just count it off and I'll pop in there and I'll figure it out as we go.
All right.
We'll be right back.
Well, there's an example of, you can just lay it down, I'll find a guitar. want to come up?
Not a chance after that.
But Ben obviously has spent some time working on a lot of stuff. Go ahead, and go if you as you get older, just like learning a language when you're young is easy. And people, when kids are young, they can learn, you know, if they got somebody around who speaks Spanish or French or Italian or whatever, you end up being bilingual or trilingual or whatever else. Because that just kind of proves out even more than ever that it's a language, you know. And like any language, my wife's Italian and she always gets mad at me because I don't speak any Italian. And I always tell her, well, I'm still working on English, which is actually true. I'm still working on, you know, English is kind of my hobby, you know. Word origins and history of words, and I got crazy ass books on stuff like that and things like that. But
English is a tough language.
What's that?
English is actually a tough language.
It is a tough language. There's a great book by a guy named Bill Bryson called Mother Tongue, and it explains why English is the way it is, why the T is silent in the word often.
I don't understand.
Yeah, he explains a lot of it in that book. What they've done is taken a lot of different languages, put them together, and tried to overlay Latin grammar, which doesn't really work in the so it's a funny so
you like
exactly exactly so the point being that obviously music for a young gentleman like Ben, his mind, when you're younger, your mind obviously is a little different, and you take to the language a little bit differently. Maybe the doctor would have a better insight than I about this, but who knows. So it doesn't necessarily it can be intimidating for an older person sometimes to see some kid whip through the language. Same way as I see some little kid speaking in you know, Farsi and then Espanol and then answering something else in Italian. Wow, you know, I'm still working in English, you know. But it's the nature of the beast. It's the nature of the beast, and I think that's why it's good now to understand more about it, because it proves out that music is basically a language. And just as spoken languages are assimilated easier by younger folks, music is as well, but it doesn't eliminate the advantage we have as older folks, because we have a more disciplined approach, we have a more focused goal, we oftentimes see the big picture. So sometimes a little kid playing 3 years can get the same up to same skill level as somebody who's been playing for 10 years. But then when you're 40, 35 or 40, I think a similar thing happens. You can take an instrument, like today I was working with my friend Kathy, who's, how long have you been playing, Kathy?
Just under 4 years.
Since what?
About 4 years.
4 years. And right away, I see her facility, her ability to move around, her ability to duplicate what I'm talking, explain it to her, and she gets it, and she reapplies it later on in the neck. And I'm not trying to blow any smoke here, Kathy. But it's all true. And it's interesting, from my point of view, a lot of times to work with people like we do here today, different guitar players, different drummers, and I'll take away more from this than any of you will, I guarantee it, because I learn so much when I'm trying to explain things to other players. And again, like I said at the beginning, as a caveat, that this is just my opinion, and I could be way wrong. That's why if I say something that may not quite fit with how you see yourself, you're probably right more than I am, that's for sure. But it's just an interesting thing to see a young man like that come up and have facility. And have a goal as an instrument, because usually I weep for the future, but now there's hope.
Right on.
Want to play a little bit?
Sure. Come on. Can we do something easy?
What's that?
Can we do something easy?
Sure.
Okay.
Easy like Sunday morning. Do you know any Van Halen?
I don't.
Any drummer know any Van Halen?
Robbie.
Can we do Panama?
Do you mind us letting another guy up?
Yeah, sure.
I don't remember Panama. I might be able to fake my way through if I see your hands. And then the first house. You know how Panama goes? Which one do you know best?
Probably
Competition. Competition. You know which one?
It'll be sloppy or hell.
Now, is there another? Try to find one that works the best. If it's like this, what would you know another Van Halen song?
Something that's not quite so difficult. I'm sure.
Maybe you might know a different one that he also knows.
What do you know besides Half a Teacher? Yeah, he brokering a song.
Probably the Devil.
All right, that's fine.
Oh, the Devil's good. See, if they did this in the Mid East, we'd probably be out of the woods by now. It's got to be awaited. Okay.
Give us some thought now.
Oh, you're an excellent player. And yeah, so we had some, who else wants to play? I see guys with sticks there. Who you want to sit down?
Oh, yeah, someone wants to play.
What do you want to do?
What do you want to do?
Let's see. How about that? Look at me. Misty. What kind of, does somebody want to play guitar with us on this?
Any guitar players?
Let's jump in again?
Sure.
We get a guitar player shortage, which is pretty rare.
You know how to play a dick with that, right?
On the magazine records, guitar this, guitar that, guitar the other thing, guitar another thing. Drummer, bass.
What was that you were talking about?
I didn't know if he knew I played the same Mr. Big Tracks like a dick to that
We'll be right back.
I didn't hear you drift from time at all, which whenever I hear a drummer do that, it just sets me at ease. Sets the whole band at ease. And I was trying to impress upon a couple of the drummers that played the other day, who again had some fine facility, but they were doing fills and not really landing exactly where they could have, should have, but you were nailing them. So you must have played in a bunch of bands.
I'm actually a studio drummer.
See, can't do it. Try to get the ringer past me, you can't do it.
Yeah, I'm on stage a lot, and I'm a new studio
so. From what area?
Columbus, Ohio.
Oh, cool, right on. There you go. Yeah. So. Yeah, you obviously have a professional level chops, since
it's different than the. I mean, you see the licks and the chops come in, but it's a different kind of approach to it. It's about you guys, not me.
Exactly. And as I'm sure you very well know.